I'm gonna be honest, I struggled to make this video. Like, really struggled.
Wow.
Today, we're going to talk about drugs and video games. Because 3 weeks ago, I went to Steam, bought some DSP, heated it up with a spoon, and injected it straight into my veins. For like 8 days straight. Now, I know DSP sounds like some sort of crazy designer drug, but DSP is actually Dyson Sphere Program. It's a factory game where the whole goal is to build a Dyson Sphere. And in my opinion, it is more addictive than drugs could ever be. And it got me thinking about games that are definitely worse than crystal meth. So I devised a new type of tier list. And because all these games are top tier at what they're trying to do, we don't need a full tier list. We only need the top three. First off, we have S tier, or meth tier. Behind that, we have A tier, which we can call heroin tier. And lastly, we have the lower B tier, which can be crack tier. And because I've already put 100 hours into this game, and me and my wife have gotten to a couple fights over it, we're assigning DSP an S tier methamphetamine-like effect. But anyways, let me tell you about some of the games that have ruined my life, and maybe yours. Also, there's a quick announcement at the end, so maybe stick around. First up, we have my first love, Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. Now, if you've been watching my videos for a while, you probably know how much I love this game. It's just the best. And when I was a dumbass kid with a PlayStation 2, San Andreas was a magical playground. I loved getting into gang fights against rival weak-ass gangs. I also loved going to strip clubs because at age 11, blocky polygon boobs were pretty cool. They still are, let's be honest. Or just getting into a random gunfight with any cop that looked at me. There was just so much to do. So many collectibles, so many cities to visit, so many side activities. And because there's this long, non-stop list of things to see and do, I spent most of my summer as a child inside killing hookers, instead of being outside and doing, you know, sports stuff. So I'm gonna give San Andreas an S tier, Walter White level meth effect. Next up, we have Rocket League, a game that I'm good, not great at, but I have still wasted hundreds of hours in all the same. Me and my brother would play for hours while we chugged beers during goals and in between matches. And because matches were only 5 minutes, it's really hard to put down. You can't quit on a win streak, but you can't end the night on a loss. It's a paradox. Also, there's no power-ups, specials, or upgradable equipment. So the only way to do better at the game was to simply get good. And oh lord, did I try. So I ended up topping out at about Diamond 2. However, my brother is currently a grand champ. And that fucking sucks for me. I'm the older brother. I'm supposed to be better. Fuck you, Zach. However, I do my best not to get roped back into the game these days, because it definitely will put more stress into my life than fulfillment. Also, a quick side note on this game, Coach, the guy who used to make videos with me, spoiler alert for the ending announcement, plays Rocket League with a mouse and keyboard. Yeah, LOL, right? But yeah, this is a B-tier crack cocaine type game for me. I just need all that boost. Now, I almost regret this next one, and that's Grand Theft Auto V Online. When GTA Online first launched, it was everything I ever wanted. I spent hours grinding missions with friends for virtual bullshit money. I even beat the Criminal Mastermind Challenge, which is where you get 10 million for beating all the heists in a row with the same crew without dying. It's pretty tough. More interestingly, I completed it with a random group of people I met on Reddit. One of them was from Bangladesh, which is the complete opposite side of the world from where I live. Another one was from Trinidad and Tobago, and the last guy was from Germany. Yeah, truly an international team. Anyways, I said almost because GTA Online today is a complete fucking mess. Pretty much, if you don't have a hoverbike or a heat-seeking missile launcher, you're gonna have a bad time. And I'm pretty sure the only person who could afford enough shark cards to buy everything in the game now is Jeff Bezos. For real, it's ridiculous. I talk a lot about this in another video. You should go check that one out. But yeah, GTA Online was as addicting as crystal meth to me, or worse. S tier for sure. So I'm sure a lot of you haven't played this next game, but it's one of my all-time favorites, and that's Satisfactory. I've been wanting to do a video on this game for a while now. But the only thing that gets views on this channel is Pokemon or Grand Theft Auto, so I haven't got the chance to talk about it yet. In Satisfactory, you play as an industrialist alien that's trying to suck all the natural resources out of a planet through building factories. Get it? Like, satisfactory? Factory? It's next level wordplay. It's really good. These kind of games force you to set your own goals and lets you figure out how to achieve them on your own. They also don't let me sleep very much, because there's always more work to be done. And before you know it, the sun's coming up, your boss is calling you, and your dad thinks you're dead, because all week, every calorie in your body has gone to ensuring your factory is running at maximum efficiency. Now, I get this game isn't for everyone. It's a lot of math and designing and headaches. But for me, watching materials flow around my factory in and out of different assembly machines, it's better than sex. And for that, I'm gonna give this game an S-tier meth level addiction as well. Coffee Stain is it's a great studio. You might remember them from Goat Simulator. Yeah, who'd have thought that studio would have made a factory game? Next up, we have Civilization 5 or 6. And these games made me hate board games, which in turn got me in more trouble with my wife. I mean, Settlers of Catan is cool and all, but can you launch nukes in it? No. No, you can't. Civ is like a giant board game that you can play by yourself. And I know it sounds lonely, because it is, but that's fine, because once you fall down Sid Meier's rabbit hole, you won't need friends anymore. The big problem with the game is it's nearly impossible to put down until you've either been conquered or you conquer everyone else. And this is because of the turn-based system that ensures you keep going. It's always one more turn, it's never time for bed. So fuck this game for all the hours of sleep it's stolen from me. B-tier cracked game. Alright, now our last one is a series, not just a single game. And that series is none other than Fallout. And yes, even Fallout 76, which is weird because I've talked a lot of shit about that game on this channel, and I'm still like level 80 in the game. I played the shit out of it, but I played it because it's Fallout, and for some reason, I need it. From Fallout 4 to the originals in the 90s, I've played them all. Hell, I even love Fallout Shelter, the mobile game. Shit's a banger. I always just get so engrossed in the lore and the stories of the world. There's nothing like listening to soft 1950s swing music while you brutally murder everything you come into contact with, while high off your ass on a frat house worth of drugs. High off drugs in the game, not in real life. You know what I mean? In real life, it'd probably be cool too, you know? I personally was addicted to the settlement building, which I know a lot of people who love Fallout aren't the biggest fans of. But for me, it was awesome. I personally rebuilt America. You can thank me in the comments for that. I even got 1 million views on Reddit for this Fallout penthouse I made, which was great for me because my wife insisted that nobody cared about the dumbass settlements I was building in Fallout. So each one of those 10,000 upvotes I got just proved her a little more wrong. Anyways, I'm gonna assign Fallout as A tier. It's good medicine for me. Okay, announcement time. If you've been a viewer of this channel for a while now, you probably noticed something's a little different. I changed the name from Ego Elite to Ego Trip. Ego Elite was a parody name that we came up with to make like a fake esports team, and we wanted it to sound like as douchey as possible. That's the origin of our old name. So it was always just a dumb meme, and I've always kind of wanted to change it. The reason I'm changing it though is because Coach, the other part of this channel, is moving on to different projects, leaving me solely in charge of this channel. So I hope you're fine with me, and if you're not, just unsubscribe. I don't want you here anyways then, because this is my channel now. I might even branch out of gaming. Hell, I might make a 2-hour long documentary on the history of hot dogs. Because fuck it, why not? But that's all in the future, the channel's not going anywhere, and I hope you guys will stick around with me. And of course, thanks for watching.
Wow, what a great video.